I've got some mail from one of my fans I'd like to share with everybody. This came from Alan up in Canada. On YouTube, he goes by the name of Samson Skates. Alan, I actually got this a couple days before my derby, but I just didn't have time to make a video on it or even mess with the stuff that you sent me because of how far behind we're with the car, and we had to bust butt to get it done. So I apologize for that. But here it is now. And what he sent me here is some bearings from a skateboard. And his idea that he suggested to me was for my shifters that I put in the floor of my cars. So instead of putting a washer and then unloosening the bolt a little bit when I shift my handle, I put one of these bearings in place and run a bolt through it and tighten it down all the way. So when my shifter handle moves, it'll just run alongside of this bearing. I don't have to ever worry about my nuts breaking loose or anything like that on the shifter. So I didn't have time to put one of these bearings on my shifter in the Thunderbird, because we were just really far behind in getting that thing done. But I am going to put one of these bearings on my shifter for the Lincoln. I'm working on this thing if we get it ready in time. So we'll see how that goes. Hopefully it should work. I think it should. For what Alan's saying, it sounds about right. And here's just to go to show you how good our mail system is down here where I live. Originally, this letter was sent to me in this normal envelope here, and somebody actually ripped off the corner of this envelope to take whatever was inside of it. They probably thought it was like Canadian money or something. Then when they saw it was just bearings, they shoved them back in here and it stayed in the mail system. Had it been one of the mail workers. Well, that happened when it was up in Canada. And up in Canada, they sent that envelope inside of this plastic wrap saying, "We're sorry, but your mail was damaged on the way to delivery, yada, yada, yada," a bunch of stuff like that. Well, even though they put this thing in a plastic bag with that envelope inside of it, somebody else ripped open the plastic bag once this envelope made its way into the U.S. And again, they tore it open and pulled out whatever was inside, saw it was only those bearings, and they put it back in. And then it finally made its way to my house. That just goes to show you how bad the mail system is sometimes. Even the own mail workers will rip through people's mail just to try to steal money out of it. This isn't the first time I've ever had this happen. I have had a lot of items. Me and my family, our mail gets looked through a lot of what gets taken out. And we'll find things that have been re-taped shut on the back, or they'll be ironed back on in the back. So if you guys ever send anything money-related in the mail to somebody else, you better really make it secure or put it in a box or just do it so nobody else can get to it and use that money instead, because odds are it might not make it there. Just a heads up for anybody. But yes, thanks a bunch, Alan, for these bearings. We're going to mess around with them, see what we can come up with. Pretty cool idea you got going on here. And if anybody else ever has any random, I don't know, car parts or magnets and stickers they want me to stick on my car, or heck, if anybody has anything Ford related, you know, Ford magnets, Ford sayings, not against Ford, for Ford. Oh, I'd love to have something like that. We'll stick it on with my Ford engine and put it on all my cars I run. I'm one of the very few people at our derby that run a Ford engine. Not many at all do. Very rare. So if anybody ever has anything random they want to send, just send me a message or something. I'll give you my address. We'll see if we can get it on one of our cars.